डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन कंटिन्यूशन वी हैव टू एनालिसिस ऑफ इंडक्शन मोटर ड्राइव्स बाय मैथमेटिकल प्रॉब्लम्स. सो योर सब्जेक्ट नेम इज इलेक्ट्रिकल ड्राइव्स एंड टुडे वी टेक अदर प्रॉब्लम्स, मैथमेटिकल प्रॉब्लम्स विच क्लियर द concept and operation of induction motor drive with variation of frequency, voltage and other parameters. So now come in this slide. So you have shown these are the basic equations. Always in all videos we reflect these equations because of these are the key equations for understanding the performance of induction motor drives. So here we take another problems. These problems very very important for exam purpose. So you prepare for the exam, we give the information about. So we here take other problems for in talk about. When we talk about constant VIF control method, then what is the performance of induction motor drives? So for constant VIF control for an inverter feed induction motor, so here, so that the torque is proportional to slip frequency. So here we can see, if we change the slip frequency, then what is the impact of torque of the induction motor drives? Assumption, neglect, stator impedance. So that is the meaning. Stator impedance, that is the losses or voltage drop across the stator parameter, resistance or reactance will be a ignored neglect for this operation. So why? From the review of induction motor from the equivalent circuit, we write the relation why the simple current voltage resistance relation. So simply define the definition. The current is the ratio of voltage upon impedance. So here denominator part of this equation is represent the impedance. So this is the ratio I2 equal to V1 upon R2 upon S plus JX2. For consideration is this equation, always keep in mind all quantities are referred to stator. That is the meaning. All rotor parameters refer to stator sides. So here we can write other relations as V1 upon R2 plus JX2 in terms of slip, and hence the torque T. You can see from previous slides, torque here. So here we represent the torque T equal to 3 upon omega s. Omega s synchronous speed in terms of slip square, V1 square, R2 upon s, R2 plus sx2 square. So these are the all parameters referred to stator side, R2, X2, these are. So under normal operating condition, we neglect stator impedance. So R2 greater than X2. In normal condition, we have seen the value of resistance is higher, much higher as compared to reactance of the stator rotor winding X2. So here we ignore x2. So this relation, this torque relation nearly about as v1 square upon f r2 ka square into r2. So this as v1 upon f r2. Since the rated frequency, rated speed is directly proportional to the frequency from the equation first. You can see from this relation, equation first. So we introduce in first slides, always keep in mind. So here, however, we define the slip already, but here s equal to ns upon nr into ns. Here we assume difference of the frequency del f upon f, del f being the slip frequency. So now come this torque equation, come in this form, v1 square del f upon f into r2f. And at the end of last, we clear the torque produced, developed by the induction motor is directly variation in the frequency, slip frequency, here del f being the frequency. So the torque is proportional to slip frequency. You can see here torque. So this Hans proof, torque in induction motor is directly proportional to the slip frequency. Here slip frequency is the difference between synchronous speed minus rotor speed. We discuss other problems. You see here, we take other problems for inverter feed induction motor. Shows that as its supply frequency is lower, starting torque increases, and state and its application is a very very important for exam point of view. Okay, what is the application of this operation of the drives? The four feed induction motor drives prove that the supply frequency is low. If supply frequency is lower, then starting torque is increases, or if starting torque is increases, then this type of application where we use in the practically. So actually the application of this thought where we required starting torque is high, so in the application of the traction, where traction, in traction drive motors required a high starting torque, so we applied this method. Where? So now we come from the basics of the induction motor drive. We have seen earlier in first slides, if voltage drop across the stator impedance is ignored for the constant gear flux, then the supply voltage is directly proportional to induced EMF in stator winding, and induced EMF in stator winding is directly proportional to rotor induced EMF, and rotor induced EMF is directly proportional to speed of the induction motor. So, and maximum torque is constant. So that is, as long as applied voltage is proportional to frequency, then the maximum available torque at any frequency remains fixed value. So also at any slip, the torque is given by, from the theory of induction motor, T equal to T max 2As upon A square plus S square, while we take here A equal to R2 upon X2. That's why, that is the starting torque, TST equal to T max 2A upon A square plus 1. Why? Because of, at the time of starting, at the time of starting of the induction motor, slip equal to 1, high. That is the means motor is stationary position. So we take a s equal to 1 and put this value as equal to 1, then we get starting torque in terms of maximum torque, 2a upon a square plus 1. So in continuation, next slides, since in previous slides we take a equal to r2 upon x, the ratio of rotor resistance upon x, rotor reactance, and rotor being independent of the frequency in terms, that is the means the rotor resistance r2 is not depend on the frequency, but reactance of the rotor is directly proportional to the frequency as well as speed. So we can write a equal to this parameter, a proportional to 1 upon omega. Finally, starting torque equal to constant, because of we take it, the maximum value is constant. So omega upon v square plus omega here, where v is another constant we take here. So thus it is evident for low value of omega, starting torque Tst is higher from equation first, because the denominator of equation 1 decreases at a greater rate than the numerator. Greater rate than the numerator. Numerator may itna increase nahi hoga. From, you can see this relation. Here omega square, here only omega. So that from equation first, the denominator of equation 1 decreases at a greater rate than the numerators. So the application, it is an advantage in traction application at a start, at the time of start. If the frequency of the supply is made low, obviously the applied voltage in proportionally lower, starting torque is comparatively high. So this type of drive system we use in a traction. Now continue, we take another problems 6. This is the mathematical problems. What is the impact of current? Current is the main important parameters, because when you design the drives, so we keep in mind current is key points. So here the problem, a 3-phase 440 volt 1000 rpm slip ring induction motor is operating with 4% slip. Stator current is 30 ampere. Calculate the stator current if the speed of the motor is reduced to 500 rpm using stator voltage control method. Actually, basic need of this problem, how we understand the specification of the drives. So we take, we give an example how we solve this type of problems. If it comes in examination, so we take seriously. So the torque being a constant in consideration, calculate the stator current. So for 1000 rpm condition, let the stator current be I1 while the slip is S1, corresponding to I1 current slip S1, and stator current being I2 corresponding to slip S2. So by the relation of the torque, T is directly proportional to I1 square R2 upon S1. So here, and we take a torque is constant, so I2 square R2 upon S2, in both condition torque is constant. So we comes this relation I1 square upon I2 square upon S1 upon S2. So we take here I1 upon I2 square root of S1 upon S2. Put the value. S1 is given 0.04 because of 4% slip. S2. So how we calculate S2? So S2 equal to this is speed 1000 and next operating speed 500 rpm divided by this. into 100 into 100. So 50%, that is the means 0.5. Since I1 equal to 30 ampere. So 30 upon I2. So put these values in this equation and we get by the I2. So we can see from this relation, thus the current at speed of 500 rpm is 106 ampere. If we decrease the speed of the motor, the stator current is increased from 30 ampere to 106 ampere. This is the key points. Okay, what is the increment of the current if we decrease the motor? Because of that time, the forward braking operation. This is the clear. Okay, thank you.
बन रही है।